An alternative to dumping code into the kernel is to leave the stub in the user space itself, but have a structured mechanism for communication between the client stub and the kernel. And that structured mechanism is a shared descriptor. And the shared descriptor is a way by which the stub can describe to the kernel that here is some stuff sitting in the user space, and I'm going to tell you how exactly you can extract this information from the user space and construct it into this buffer for transmission on the wire. Recall what I told you earlier, and that is the kernel has no idea of the semantics of this call, and therefore it has no knowledge of the actual arguments, the data structures that are being used in the call. So what we're going to do is use the shared descriptor as a vehicle for the stub to communicate to the kernel the data structures that need to be passed. So for instance, let's say that the argument for the call has four parameters. Then this descriptor has four entries, and each entry is saying this is the starting point of a particular data item, and this is the length of the data item. This is the starting point of the second data item, and this is the length of the data item. Third data item, fourth data item. Kernel doesn't have to know the semantics of these data items. All it needs to know is what is the starting address for a particular data item and what is the length of that data item. That's all it needs to know. And this is the descriptor that allows the stub to inform the kernel about the arguments, how many arguments there are, and what is the size of each argument. It doesn't have to tell the kernel, oh, here is an integer, here is a floating point, here is an array. No, none of that. All that the stub is doing is it's saying, here is the starting address for an argument, and here is the length of that argument. Because usually data structures are organized contiguously. So if you have an integer, it is occupying four contiguous bytes in memory. If you have a floating point number, it is occupying some number of contiguous bytes in memory. And therefore, what the stub is doing is it's creating the shared descriptor that is providing the information to the kernel in the layout of the arguments on the stack. And once the layout of the arguments on the stack are known to the kernel, then the kernel can use discontiguous data items that are living on the stack, described as the shared descriptor, and create a contiguous packet in its internal buffer. That's the second way you can do in order to reduce the number of copies from 2 to 1. So in both cases, what we've done is either the first approach of pushing the client stub into the kernel, or the second approach of having a shared descriptor between the user stub, which is living in user space, and the kernel in order to describe the layout of the data structures that need to be assembled into a network packet by the kernel using the shared descriptor. Both of these allow us to reduce the number of copies from 3 down to 2. Either there is one copy that is happening going from the stack into the kernel buffer, and the second copy, as I said, is inevitable if the network controller is requiring a DMA to be done from the system memory into its internal buffer before the bits can be pushed out on the wire. So that's the first source of overhead. And so these are techniques that we have looked at, two different techniques for reducing the copying overhead, that is the dominant part of marshalling the arguments. And this happens on both sides. It happens when the client has to push the arguments to the server side, and it happens again on the server side when the server has to push the results back to the client. So the marshalling is happening on both ends, and for both ends, we can use this technique of using a shared descriptor or pushing the client stub or the server stub into the kernel in order to reduce the number of copies from 2 down to 1.